finally, perhaps the most important speaker for us today, who's actually from Brent Castle. But I'm afraid our time is so short, so we're sort of rushing now. But you are the most important speaker, and I hope that you will take it back. I'd like to introduce Cllr Harbi Farah, who is the Castle. Years, and he works also with
Help Somali
Foundation.
Thank you. I'm conscious about the time, and I like the philosophical question that the previous speaker asked, how do you define the situation? But I want to practically also ask you questions about, do we know how the Muslims are diverse as well, in terms of color, in terms of culture, in terms of understanding about the religion, and we're all in one box. And some of us can navigate on the system, and some of us do not even know what the reality is. So the Muslims we're talking about are diverse as we are in this room as well. I won't talk about anything much, but I just want to say, in terms of the council has got a statutory responsibility when it comes to the prevention agenda. And the previous speakers also mentioned about schools as well. As you may know, in Brent, almost all the Brent secondary schools are academies now. So the council have little or no influence at all how they govern themselves. In terms of the leader of the council, or those of us in the council, like Liz Dixon, not able to meet with your concerns or some of your representatives, I'm more than happy to listen. I'm also arranging meeting with either leader or those strong communities lead member. Speaking to him this afternoon, as well as the council leader, I'm coming here today. I'm more than happy before the Christmas that meeting will happen as well. In terms of the voluntary sector, when the council was mentioned as well as the introduction was included. I'm also in the daytime work in the voluntary sector, as I've been for the last couple of years. We came from a long way with the voluntary sector in Brent. We used to have what we call Brava, which collapsed, and now we have got a vibrant organization called Cllr. The relationship between the voluntary sector and the council was excellent, but it's still improving. And more than that, last year as a councillor, I was the chair of the voluntary sector liaison forum in the council. And the first meeting I chaired was about what the members want about the voluntary sector forum to look like and how they want to shape with the view of facilitating them to have the views and the agenda decided by them. As a result of that, now the voluntary sector completely run by the Brent CBS and not supported by the Council of Users. Honestly, pleased to be invited here and thank all this audience who came. We have a lot of issues about prevent, and I'm not here to defend, but being a Muslim as a Somali as well, as you may hear last week, the staff in Leytonstone and happened to be a Somali gentleman, nothing to do with terrorism, but really was a mental health issue. And for this whole week, I was one of those community members who was supporting the family how to deal about it, because they find themselves a gentleman who was mentally disturbed for the last 5 years being judged or accused as terrorism. So, resident in Brent, I don't want these things to happen in Brent. I would like to involve all the things that we can improve local residents. And thank you very much. If there's any questions, I'll answer.
Thank you very much. Unless there's any really sort of urgent, immediate question, because time's running on and we need to move on and give London Interface Centre a rest, really.
I've got a question.
Yeah.
I've got a question.